Hello everyone, I am Dr. Fayaz Maiman from Mumbai and today I am going to teach you arthroscopic knot tying. I am not going to speak about the application, you all know it. So amongst the knots, we have got a stationary knot and the sliding knot. Stationary knot is the one in which the two limbs of the suture don't move from the origin or from the place where the anchor is put. Whereas in the sliding knot, the two limbs of the sutures can be can slide through the anchor or the soft tissue where repair is to be done. So there are several sliding knots which are described, but if we teach you more than one, you're going to get confused. So I'm going to teach you only one sliding knot, and that one sliding knot is going to be sufficient for all your arthroscopic surgeries. The second thing is a stationary knot. There also there are several stationary knots which are described, but I'm going to teach you only one so that you should know at least one sliding knot and one stationary. Remember, a sliding knot cannot be substituted for a stationary knot. However, a stationary knot can be substituted for the sliding knot. The technique of arthroscopic knot tying is important because normally when you tie knots in your day-to-day life, the things are open and you're looking at the knot where you're going to tie it, and you have got sufficient space to tie the knot. However, when you are doing an arthroscopic surgery, you are not inside the joint, you are outside the joint, and you have to take these knots in a secure fashion by standing outside. So you need to know how it is to be done, which I'm going to show you. So first we are going to talk about the sliding knot, and this is the suture which goes through the anchor over here. You can consider this as anchor, and this is how the thread slides. Okay, now these are the two limbs. While we take a knot, we need to know on which side the knot has to go. The side on which the knot goes is the post. Now consider that this is the post. So when this is the post, I make this post smaller because this is the one thread which I'm going to pull. The post is small, okay, and now I hold the post in my thumb and middle finger and keep my index finger below the thread, below the post. Now I'm going to turn this thread over my finger and put one throw, the second one, and the third one goes through this. Once I do this, I remove my finger and slightly tighten this, and I need this knot to go right up to there. In a sliding knot, we don't push the knot, we actually pull the post. So when I pull the post, the knot automatically goes and secures there. You can see the knot over there. So usually this is a small instrument called knot pusher, which pushes the knot over there. This is for the actual thread. I'm showing you the larger version. So I've made this, customized this to show how the knot pusher works. So we put the thread through the knot pusher, and from outside the joint, we push. We push it there, pull the post and push the knot. Okay, so this is how it gets secured. So you can see this knot, it's tight. However, a sliding knot can always back out. So this needs to be backed up by a few half inches. So I take 3 half inches, which are going to be similar to the stationary knots. And I'm going to show you the stationary knot after this. Little amount of practice is going to make things easy, and it doesn't take much time. So you can see this is the post. I have put 1, 2, and the third one goes in this first hole, and that's how you tighten it, and once you pull, the knot gets secured. Now I'm going to teach you a stationary knot. Now here is the scenario where there are 2 suture limbs which cannot slide because there is a knot already tied. So in this situation, I cannot have a sliding knot, so I'm going to take a stationary knot. The other reason you need to know about stationary knot is that you need to take 1/2 inches to secure the sliding knot. So now this is the first suture limb and this is the second suture limb, both of which I am holding between my thumb and index finger. Now, for time being, for the understanding, we would consider this as first suture limb. Now, I am going to turn my three ulnar fingers over the first post and take a turn like this. Keep the second post over my three fingers. Take my middle finger over the first post and take the knot like this. Now this knot is going to be pushed by my knot pusher right up to the knot over there. So it's going to be like this. So just for understanding how we push, standing outside the joint is like this. For understanding, I'm going to keep the knot over here at the moment. Now this is simple half hitch. So this is not going to be a secure knot. Okay, so I'm going to take another half hitch. Okay, and this is again going to be like this. Now these are the similar knots. If you see, these are similar knots. So here you can see these are identical knots. This limb going from there and coming here, going from there and coming here. Now these both knots will get pushed right up to there over here and this is secure. However, we need to have one locking knot and that cannot be similar to the one which we have put there. So for this, what is the easy method? Either you do the opposite of this, which is difficult to do otherwise for a newcomer, or else use another hand with another suture limb. So something that I did with my number one post, now you're going to do with the number two post. So just turn your three ulnar fingers and take the knot like this. Now you can see that this knot is opposite to the previous two. So you can see these are same and this is coming opposite. So this, now when this secures to the previous knots and you push with your knot pusher, it tightens. The knot tightens over here and then it is so secure that it cannot back out and your construct is strong. So once you do like this, once you reach here, you should pass point. So you just go down and push the knot pusher and pull the other limb like this. Okay, can you see that? So once you reach there, you just pass point and cross the knot so that the two limbs are pulling each other in opposite direction. So I'm going to show you now the arthroscopic view of how we take a sliding knot as well as the stationary knot over it in one go. I would like everyone to remember only one sliding knot and one stationary knot. Otherwise, there are very high chances that you guys get confused. I thank you very much for your kind attention and thank Bombay Orthopedic Society to have given me this opportunity to help you learn arthroscopic knots. Thank you very much.